During our carefree days, we'd swim the pool, diving off the side, after pennies thrown, retrieving them from the bottomless deep near the big drains, then rising up, breathless. Still at the garden, my mind back from flight, the gardener beckoned me inward, and I leaned over the fence to smell a flower, and a thousand memories reoccurred. Each morning, glory blossom lives but for a single day and is replaced by another, each in succession shining in its morning glory, wilting in noon's heat. Withering quickly in the afternoon, then languishing throughout the evening. Their happy message to us being that another day will always come on.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I.
The amaranth intrigues, its leaves never fade, even long after death, ever remaining vivid red. Could it be somehow that a portion of the immortal lives on there? There, the blinding luminosity of sunflowers, we dried the seeds and ate them, each still a glowing ember of memory of the bright days among a thousand suns.
What a wonderful world.
I drank up buttercup potions of the bright yellow light from the elfin goblets and entered the realm of fairies, pixies, fays, trolls, goblins, brownies, gremlins, and sprites. Thank you.
skies of blue and clouds of white.
We had cherries and a grape arbor too, eating them fresh, competing with squirrels and birds, always forgetting to wash them, so sour they were, then spit out the seeds. I walked on and saw a lake surrounded by old and broken down vacation cabins. Of course, we were never there yet when we asked, but soon dozed off, tired of asking. We dug the worms at night, keeping them moist, and got up with the sun to fish and then skin them and cook them for lunch or dinner. This to me is America remembered. Dad was always out fishing, my brother too, and me less often. Now I clearly see that fishing has little to do with fish, but with cool breezes, moist air, peace, and quiet. I wore my life preserver all day long. Once I leaned over for a closer look and fell in, swimming with the fishes, then pushed up, my life jacket now broken in. We puttered to a mysterious island, and there we found nothing, but camped for lunch, feeling like pirates, and telling no one about it until a whole day later.